than what I could do. And that is where I think he is seen as a very, very popular judge. Just Mr. Bhatia today said, our very most popular judge, as Mr. Sinha mentioned, his most popular judge. His passion for cricket, we have seen how it was mentioned by Mr. Sinha, and his compassion for human beings also. I remember when we were hearing this BCCI matter, I felt as though a former captain of the Indian cricket team is sitting with me, because he had so much insight into the working of the BCCI and how cricket is played and how considerations prevail. I am eternally grateful to him for helping me and for helping the game as such in some measure regain its glory. When it came to human compassion, we were hearing a case where the issue was whether one can be sentenced to consecutive life sentences to undergo. There was a case which came from Madras, his own state. Somebody had committed 8 murders, so he was sentenced to undergo 8 life sentences. The question was whether this is permissible. And I saw his compassion in that also. We held that humans have but one life, and therefore there is no question of undergoing 8 different life sentences. All told, Justice Kalifullah is a man with abundant amount of patience, prudence. But what is, I think, the most notable thing about him is that he is full of nobility. And today, when we were sitting after the last day's work, he mentioned to me that his father, who was also a judge of the Madras High Court, always used to, crave that his last days should be spent in Mecca. See, Mecca is the holiest of the places for Muslims. He visited Mecca, he was in Mecca, and died in Mecca. And his father is buried in Mecca. Now, what more could a Muslim ask for? It is only nobility, perhaps, which could take you to the holiest of the places on earth, where, you see, to find a resting place for himself. I think this is in the family, and that is what I think really matters. Eventually, in human life, all that is around us is ephemeral. It is the nobility of the individual, the nobility of the person, which is remembered. Judges come, judges go, judges are sometimes power charged, judges are, you see, they think no end of themselves in terms of their scholarship and all. But I think what is ultimately what touches human mind, or what remains in the memory of humans, is the nobility of the individual. And that you can see from the face of the man, from the way he conducts himself, from the way he treats others. And that is very important. We'll miss him, and most of our brother judges, we will miss him, and so will the bar. But then I'm reminded of a Punjabi couplet. A Punjabi poet has put it very beautifully. The Punjabi poet, I hope all of you understand, but I'll translate it also for Brother Kalifullah. The couplet says, Sada na bulbul bole bagaan, sada na bag baharaan, sada na bulbul bole bagaan. The bulbul doesn't sing in the garden forever. Sada na bag baharaan. The spring is not eternal in the garden also. Sada na rendi husn jawani, youth and beauty also is not there for all times. Sada na sobate yara, and the company of your companions and your friends is also not there forever. Sada na bole bulbul baga, sada na bag bahara, sada na rendi husn jawani, sada na sobate yara. So that is how it is. Nothing is forever, nothing is eternal. It is only the memories that we carry, and I think the memories of my very, very short association with Justice Kalifullah will stay with me, as I am sure they will stay with you also, for the times you spent in his court, the treatment you got. Whether you lost or you won is not important, But the way he dealt with you, the way he treated you will be remembered. Thank you very much and God bless you.
Thank you, sir. Now, before I invite Honorable Mr. Justice Kalifullah to address this audience, I would say he'll always be remembered as a judge who delivered judgments through compassion, a judge who always smiled even when he dismissed our matters, a judge who was more like a friend to us than being a judge. And when I was looking for the right words to express his qualities, I could find some beautiful words of Milton, and I would just read them, and I think they beautifully describe all the qualities that are there in Justice Kalifullah. Unmoved, unshaken, unseduced, unterrified. His loyalty he kept, his love, his zeal. Nor number nor example with him wrought to swerve from truth or change his constant mind. Such are the qualities of Honorable Justice Kalifullah. May I now request him to deliver his address and guide us, and we are all eager to hear him, sir, please. Can we have a huge round of applause for him?
Thank you very much. My Lord, the Honorable Chief Justice of India, Justice T.S. Thakur, my brother and sister judges, my mentor and guide, Justice Sirpurkar, and my guru, Justice Chauhan, with whom I sat for a long time, who actually taught me what criminal law is, former judges of this court, my former colleagues, Justice Murugesan, former Chief Justice of Delhi High Court, Justice K.N. Basha, learned Solicitor General Dr. Ranjit Kumar, Mr. Sinha, the Vice President, Mr. Gaurav Bhatia, other office bearers of SCBA, Mr. Maithani, the Secretary General, and other registrars, senior advocates, junior members of the bar, press and media, ladies and gentlemen. I don't know whether I deserve such overwhelming shower of praise conferred on me, but I accept each and every one of them without any demur. There is also one very valid reason. Today is the judgment day for me. You are the judges of judges, and it is quite apparent that your judgment has now come in my favor. Since it is in my favor, there is no question of filing any review. You know what will be the fate of the review? If somebody else who want to work against me and file a review, I know what you will do. Right. Supposing even if a curative petition is filed, I am confident that that full bench of this forum will definitely support me. Because maybe like just Mr. Jethmalani or Mr. K.K. Venugopal or Mr. Parasuran or Mr. Fali Nariman, they may be part of that bench, a higher bench. They will are Mr. Dushyant Dave, or Mr. Sinha, or Mr. Bhatia. Even if any one of them sit in that curative bench, Dushyant Dave will not go against me, because every day he meets me in Lodi Park. And I wish him. Mr. Sinha, he is a former judge. Anyway, though he may be a senior advocate today, he was a former judge. So judges always we go together. He will not also go against me. Mr. In all probability, if someone will be against me, that may be Bhatia. Because he lost the cricket match. But I'll have majority with me. And if it is Mr. Venugopal or Fali Nariman or Mr. Parasaran or Mr. Jethmalani, I had engaged them several occasions when I was a lawyer. I had paid them huge fees. Definitely they will not go against me. So, review or curative will definitely meet its fate. The net result, I succeed before. I have succeeded before. Therefore, I accept all the prizes without any demur. See, my thanks, this is, for me, this is also a Thanksgiving day. My thanks goes to God Almighty, who gave me this opportunity to serve this society. Next goes to my parents, who groomed my career from my childhood. And as my Lord the Chief Justice put it, I followed his footsteps, and what I am here, what all you feel about me, should all go to my father and mother. Next, my wife and children. My wife is here. I had difficulties when my father died in Hornus in Mecca when he went for a pilgrimage. At that time of crisis, though she came from a very affluent family, she stood by my side and supported me like a rock, taking care of my children. Today I got the opportunity to express my gratitude to her. So I owe my gratitude to my family members, and now my relatives have come all the way from my native place, Karaikudi. I don't know what propelled them to come here. I told them they all were here when I took oath. And then without me asking, telling them anything, even in fact I told them, why do you want to come? It's a farewell only. They said, no, we'll be there. See, they are sitting here. All the way they have come from my native place just to support me. And they supported me during my career as a judge in the Madras High Court, as well as here, accepting meeting me for any of our family affairs. There was not a single occasion when they wanted to interfere with my judicial career. Therefore, I am grateful to my relatives, the representatives of them here. I owe my grateful thanks to my guru, Mr. T.S. Gopala, who groomed my professional career and the opportunities he gave to me, which made me, which enabled me to draw the eyes of my Lord Justice Sirpurkar when I argued some three writ petitions before his lordship. And that is how I got my elevation. He met me in a marriage reception and then asked me, he used to call me Ibrahim. Ibrahim, what do you think about the judgeship? I said, my Lord, that's my ambition. My father was a judge, so I am doing my best. Inshallah, let us see. These are the exact words his lordship told me. And that's how I could become a judge. And that opportunity I could get because of my guru, Mr. T.S. Gopalan, who gave me a free hand to deal with all the cases of our office. So I owe my thanks to him. I must here acknowledge that the members of the Supreme Court Bar are the best in the country. I tell you, I am not just trying to flatter you. In assisting the court in solving all legal entangles, I was greatly benefited by your assistance. And as compared to my career as a lawyer, as well as 11 years of judgeship in the Madras High Court, I now feel that I am more equipped and developed, and I have developed great confidence to deal with any situation which I may come across in my future life. So therefore, I owe my grateful thanks to every one of the members of this great institution. In the past 4 years and 4 months, I was able to discharge my duties as a judge with the able support of my home staff, who was led by Mrs. Meenu Sethi, my personal secretary, and my court masters in the court. And they were all very, very meticulous in attending to the matters, and I owe my grateful thanks to every one of them who assisted me in my home as well as in the court. I have great admiration and respect for the Chief Justices of India, along with whom I discharge my duties and functions as a judge, namely starting from Justice Kapadia, Justice Kabir, Justice Sadashivam, Justice Lodha, Justice Dattu, and now our present Chief Justice, Justice Thakur. Every one of them reposed confidence in me and gave me opportunity to deal with all types of cases, litigation, and also other assignments. And that enabled me to develop my career growth to a large extent. I owe my special thanks to Honorable Chief Justice, Justice Thakur, whom I got acquainted through Justice Sirpurkar when I was ordained to work as Chief Justice of Jammu and Kashmir High Court. He advised me, you go and meet Justice Thakur sir, before you go. And he also requested my lord to give me an appointment. I went and I met his lordship. He gave me very, very vital guidance, because it was a very difficult state, Jammu and Kashmir. But he gave me some very valuable advices. And the moment I landed there in Srinagar, that very situation happened the moment I entered the guest house. And but for this guidance, I would have committed great blunders. That guidance always was there in my head, and I could carry on for my judicial Chief Justice career there in Jammu and Kashmir for 1 year and 1 month without any scope for any controversy, and everything was peaceful. I could do lot of help to the people of that state. And the entire credit, I feel, it should go to His Lordship Justice Thakur sir. And even after coming here, I got his guidance. I am grateful to him for his kind disposition towards me. I admire my brother and sister judges, with every one of whom every day I meet in the lounge and have a sip of coffee or tea and exchange our pleasantries. I tell you, this opportunity is available only to Supreme Court judges who can meet personalities from all over the country. Judges from all over the country, from different states they come, and thereby we get the opportunity to mingle with them. Now, before I went to Kashmir and thereafter come to Delhi, I was just, my area of operation was limited to the state of Tamil Nadu alone. Now I know many, many, many friends who are very close to me, and who will help me at any matters throughout the state, whether it is Madhya Pradesh.